So we're gonna go ahead and activate it. So hopefully that'll catch the wind and it'll go up in the air. I have no idea what to expect. Here we go. Come on. Come on. Go up in the air. Fly. Fly. Oh, we need a bigger runway. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is ScrapMan bringing you another episode of Trailmakers. And today we are going to be trying to fly a kite. And I'm not too sure what I even mean by that yet, but there's a part that I have not used in any of my builds yet, and that part is the trailer hinge. And what the trailer hinge is basically a ball joint. And if you put a bunch of them stacked together, it basically makes like a chain or like a rope. And I thought it'd be kind of fun to make a land vehicle and then have some trailer hinges attached to a vehicle with aerodynamics that'll hopefully make it lift up into the air when we drive the land vehicle forward. Does that make sense? I think that, I don't know, I have no idea if this is possible or if it's gonna work, but I just thought of this idea right before recording this, and I was like, that's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna see if that works. I haven't even tested this out whatsoever, so it's gonna be an interesting process. So the first thing we're gonna need is a fast land vehicle that stays on the ground. And you know what I'm gonna use for this is I'm actually gonna use the wall climbing method that we used in a previous episode when I made the wall climber. We're gonna use the hover pads, the upside down hover blocks, as a method for keeping ourselves attached to the ground. That should work for our purposes here. Okay, so here's the basic design of the car that I have so far. Let's just make sure that, whoa, this is definitely fast. Holy cow. Wow, look how fast this thing goes. Okay, this is definitely, I think this is definitely strong enough to pull a kite behind it. Maybe a little bit too strong on the acceleration. So now let's activate the hover pads and see if this thing is a wall climber. Wait, what? Oh, maybe I deactivated them just then. All right, now, there we go. All right, so now we have a successful wall climber once again. All right, I love this wall climbing method. You can see the hover pads in there. All right, and let's see if it still has that same weird effect. If I go off of a ramp, do the hover pads reverse? Whoa, this thing is kind of hard to turn. If I go off a ramp on my other vehicle, the hover pads reverse their effects into like a... Okay, that's not what I was expecting. They had previously made me float, but now they don't appear to be having that same effect. Here, let's try this again. All right, we're gonna go ahead and go off the jump. Oh, 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 okay. All right, I'm a little bit confused. I don't know what's happening anymore. All right, let's try this again. We're gonna go off the jump. Okay, they definitely do not seem to have the floating effect, which is interesting. Okay, so this is an interesting It worked that time. That time it actually worked. What is happening with... Yeah, see, look. We have the floating effect now. Why? It wasn't working a second ago, but now it's totally working. And we are totally attached to the ground now. I'm having a little bit of trouble steering. Okay, so we have a wall climber A wall climber slash floater. So now we have to build our kite. Now, I have no idea. I have not thought through at all to how the kite should be designed. All I know is that it's gonna have to be trimmed so that it wants to lift off just by going straight. Should the kite have wheels or should we drag it across the ground? I don't know. I think we're gonna drag it across the ground for now because I'm thinking like an actual kite here, not like just a vehicle that flies. So let's see what we could do for a, oh wait, where's my vehicle? I gotta save this thing. Look at that! Oh, that's amazing. I think I can kind of understand what might be happening with these hover pads, because right now, physically, this makes no sense. The hover pads are pushing against their selves, basically. It's pushing against its own mass. So this hover pad is pushing up against this block above it, which when I'm on the ground, it pushes the hover pad down, and that translates to my entire vehicle making it attached to the ground. But when I'm not attached to the ground, it reverses the effect because then the hover pad is pushing up against that block and it translates that to the entire vehicle, making me float. It's just weird that it switches like that depending on whether or not I'm touching the ground. It is such a weird concept. But yeah, as soon as I get off the ground, look at that! I just float! Oh, that is great! All right, I love this effect. I don't know I don't know if they're gonna fix this, but I kind of think it's more of a feature than a bug. It's a really really cool cool effect. Okay, anyway, let's get to building our kite. We have this thing saved. So now what I'm thinking is I'm just gonna attach them directly to this thing. That's why I left this whole back end kind of open. So what I'm worried about is complexity. I don't know if these ball hinges, I don't know how much these add to complexity. I know wheels add a lot to complexity. So the question is, how long can we make this? Oh, look at this. Wow. Apparently these do not add a lot to complexity. I kind of went farther than I was planning on right now. I was just expecting it to stop me at some point. Okay, I just want to spawn this thing in and see if this works. Okay. Okay. Oh, there we go. All right. All right. Let's see. Let's see what this is going to be doing. Uh-oh. Oh, it doesn't let me move. That might be an issue. These things appear to have a lot of drag. Okay. Let me delete like a quarter of these and see if this helps. Oh boy. Oh boy, I did not anticipate this. Let's delete like half of them and see if this helps. Okay, we're getting somewhere now. Oh, we took our own wheel off. Wow, that's like a legit like a ball and chain style weapon. That's pretty cool. All right, come on. Oh wait, I didn't even use my thrusters. I'm stupid. I forgot I had thrusters. Holy cow, look at that. That's crazy. That is kind of crazy. Okay, let's turn back this way. Oh, that's much more manageable there. But this thing really, it really, really affects my vehicle a lot. I was not expecting how much it was gonna like drag my vehicle. So you know what I'm thinking? Oh, look at it all bunched up. That's actually kind of fun. You know what I'm thinking? We can really lower the complexity of this by using a ball bearing. Not every single one has to be a ball bearing. We can have ball bearing and then like a block and then a ball bearing and then a block. And I think that'll give us the same effect with maybe hopefully less complexity. I'm thinking about using large grid blocks in between the ball bearings. So let's see how this helps us or hurts us. I don't know. All right, so we're gonna do ball bearing, grid block, ball bearing, grid block. And I'm only gonna use one grid block even though the ball bearings take up two width, but I'm gonna just alternate them from left to right. So now if I copy this entire thing, I should be able to duplicate this, whoops, as much as I want. All right, I think this is about as long as what, maybe a little bit longer than what we were just doing. So let's see if lessening the ball bearings helps. Oh, that is so much better. Okay, I think this is definitely doable. Man, the way that this affects my turning though, like I'm gonna hold the gas open and I'm gonna try to stay straight now. Look at that, I'm not turning at all. This is all the game. This is all the tail doing this to me. That is kind of cool. All right, let's stop, reverse, go. All right, now I'm just going forward, full power forward. I'm not doing this turning. That's all the tail. This is really fun. This is a fun experiment. It's like a tail whip car. Let's see if I can whip it into this. Oh, that worked. I'm actually curious, how long then can we make this before we can't go anymore? Let's try. Oh, wait, did that just not copy? Oh, I think we've reached the breaking point. Okay. Oh, I don't know what's happening. I'm deleting a bunch of stuff and I can't see it. What is happening here? Okay, apparently that whole thing got disconnected over there. So let's try this again. All right, so it just glitched out. I tried to extend it by one more and it disappears. So let's just go with this length and hope that it doesn't break. I probably shouldn't have spawned it on that. This is gonna change things. Come on, Paul. Paul. Okay, we're gonna have to move ourselves back here. Is this even gonna... Uh-oh. It's in the rock. This is a problem. Not enough space to... Oh, no. I think we may have... Oops. There we go. That actually kind of helped. All right, let's... Can we repair here? Can we get it all back? Oh, there we go. Okay, this is too... This is clearly too long. So let's see. Let's delete, like, this much. Let's see if this is more manageable. Hey, this is pretty doable. I think we may have found our length right here. How fast can we go? Can we pick up a decent amount of speed? I think we can lift off with that. You think we can lift off with that? I think we should be able to lift off with that. Let's try this. This is fun. I like this concept. Like, I'm having enough fun with just this, to be honest. All right, you know what? I'm gonna go a little bit less, though, because we need to think about speed as well. Not just the fact that we can go, but how fast can we go? Because remember, we have to lift up an entire kite. We have to lift up a kite. I don't know how heavy that kite's gonna be. So let's see if this feels a little bit more manageable. I think this is good. I think we can handle this. Yeah, I think we could definitely handle this. All right, so now it's time to build a kite onto this. Let's save this for now though. Let's repair, make sure that we have this thing saved as a whole. Okay, now for the kite. Not too sure what I'm doing right now, but we are gonna see how this goes. All right, so this is the most basic thing I could think of. I don't know if this is gonna work, but these two are designed to tilt up so that hopefully they'll be able to catch the wind under them. And then the tail and the tail fins are basically gonna stay static, hopefully creating that kind of the curve between the two that's gonna keep it like going upwards. I don't know if this is gonna work though. There's only one way to find out. That's just the try. Oh wait, I forgot to activate it. So we're gonna go ahead and activate it. So hopefully that'll catch the wind and it'll go up in the air. I have no idea what to expect. Here we go. Come on. Come on. Go up in the air. Fly. Fly. Oh, we need a bigger runway. Where can we go for a bigger runway? Oh, we got a problem though. We're gonna have a lot of trouble spawning back. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna have a lot of trouble spawning back here. Let me go. Let me go. There we go. Okay, we need to get out of here. Oh, and then we need to repair. There we go. So now I'm gonna save this thing and we're gonna get to a better spawn point. A little thing that's a little bit more open. You know what? I got a better idea. Let's go over to Race Island and use the drag strip. Brilliant. All right, here we are. Now, the only question is the tarmac gonna... No, I don't want the race to start. Okay. Is the tarmac going to drag me more or have more grip on my kite than the dirt? And it looks like it just might. All right, let's activate the kite. All right, let's zoom all the way out here so we can actually see what's going on. And go! Go, come on, kite, lift off! Lift off! Lift off! Wait, oh, is it lift? It's lifting off! No! Oh, we kind of had it. Here, let me get rid of the UI here. All right, let's try this again. I can't believe that actually kind of worked. All right, this makes me feel like we have promise. The only issue was that I kind of had to turn for some reason and it made it go kind of crazy. All right, let's see if we could do this. Stay straight. Stay straight. Come on, get up in the air. Why are you going off to the side like that? Come on. Oh, wait, I didn't activate the thing. All right, now get up in the air. Get up in the air. Yes, go. Lift up, lift up, lift up. No. I don't want to actually do the race. I just want to get through. What if we go around? We're just going to go. Whoop. Apparently that doesn't work. We're just going to go around. Oh, there goes our tail. Oh, and there it goes. Thanks for the air horn. I appreciate that. All right, let's try this again. This time I'm going to use my thrusters from the beginning and make sure it's actually turned. That the wings are actually turned. Okay, come on. Come on, lift off. Oh, is it up? It's up off the ground. It's doing it! But it's not lifting up anymore. It's just a little bit. Come on, go! Up more! Up more. All right, you know what? I'm just gonna change the angle of the wings. We're gonna make it have a little bit more of a steep angle on these wings, and maybe it'll actually lift up a little bit stronger. Because I didn't realize is that this thing needs to be able to lift up all the weight of this. And each of these trailer bearings are 5 kilograms, and then each of these are like, I don't know, like 0.5? I don't know. So this just might not have enough lift unless we put some more wings on it, which we could totally do. But first things first, let's just make this angle a little bit steeper. Let's make it 30 degrees or around there. All right, now let's see how that looks. Okay. All right, that's definitely steeper. It's gonna take a little bit more to get this thing off the ground, I think. All right, here we go. Come on, lift off. Lift. Oh my God, it's working. We just need more wings so it can lift the entire weight of this, tail. We're making a kite, guys. It's working. I didn't expect this to be a successful experiment this quickly. Okay. All right. More wings. We need more up force. Okay. I have doubled the lift. So hopefully this will give us double the lift. That makes sense, doesn't it? I mean, it makes sense to me. All right, here we go. Okay, let's pull ourselves forward. I am so looking forward to seeing how this works. This is really exciting to me. All right, here we go. Forward, come on. Come on, you can do it. It's off already. Oh, yes. Look at it go. It's amazing. Oh boy. Oh, okay. Oh, we wrapped ourselves around the thing. It's a little bit, once you turn, like my vehicle isn't heavy enough to really handle the counter forces that happen once I turn. So I don't think there's any way we're getting out of the, oh wait, maybe there is. Maybe we can get out of this. Oh, there it goes. Okay, now I can maybe I can just repair myself here. All right, there we go. Okay, come on, lift. Oh wait, gotta press the control. Lift up, lift up, lift up. There it is, there it is. There it is, it's going. It's going, it's making me turn, but it's going. No, I don't want to finish the race. I just want to keep going. I wish there was an infinite straightaway, but I think this is the longest straightaway that we have, to be honest. All right, let's try this again. Let's see if we can make it all the way down to the goal without crashing. All right, come on, kite, get up in the air. Oh, it's so good. It's lifted up everything. Everything's off the ground too, it's working. Oh no, it's turning me. Oh no, we're in a feedback loop. Oh no, we were so close to the goal. We were so close to the goal. I am really happy at this working, guys. Like, I don't know if you can tell, but this is making me really excited and happy to see this work. I had an idea and I brought it to life. I brought it to life and it worked. My first try, it worked. We have a kite. We actually have a kite. All right, now come on, just stay steady. Stay steady. Oh, it gets into like this oscillation. We did it though. We made it all the way to the end. And look at that, it just landed. It just landed right next to me. Can we like, I wanna try to take this thing around the map, but I don't think we're gonna be able to turn without this thing losing control completely. Let's try it though. Let's see if we can just start going casually here. Oh boy, there it goes. There it goes. Oh, this is impossible. This is gonna be impossible. Oh, here we go. Here's a nice straightaway. Let's try this. All right. This is looking okay. All right, here we go. Come on, kite, get up in the air. Get up in the air. Oh, this is a good view. This is a really good view. Look at this. Look at it go. Look at it go. Oh, look at me go. I got a little bit of air there, so it caused me to go up in the air because of our hover pad issue. Okay, I have to see this on the drag strip from the rear view perspective. All right, are my wings down? Yes, my wings are down. Okay, here we go. It should get up in my view once it starts to lift up. Oh, there it is. There it is. It looks even better from this view. This is amazing. This is absolutely amazing. Oh, it's gonna, oh no. Oh. Hey, we're getting a 23-second drag mile here, or however long this is. We're getting a 23-second race on the drag strip with dragging a kite behind us. I don't know if I can improve this any better other than making my car a little bit more powerful. I kind of want to try the big wheels and see if they make a difference. Oh, it is so graceful at first. I love this thing. I really do. It is so graceful. Until it, like, starts doing that. Oh, there it goes. Hey! It still had a graceful landing over there. Okay, let's see what big wheels do. Do big wheels give us any more grip and stability with this thing, or is it gonna slow us down? You know what? We can do big wheels and we can add some more thrusters. Let's see how this goes. Oh man, these wheels are just unnecessarily big for the size of this vehicle. Oh, they're a little close together, aren't they, too? Okay, let's see how this works. All right, this thing is looking crazy. Turning is insane now. Whoa! These go a lot faster, apparently. All right, let's repair ourselves here and get ourselves back on track. Holy cow, I did not expect the big wheels to have this much more speed. This is surprising. This is genuinely surprising to me. I thought the big wheels were gonna have a lot more mass and slow us down. All right. Oh, wait, what? Oh, no. Oh, no, we have a problem. Our hover pads are now too high off the ground because of these big wheels, which means there's a solution to that. The solution is I have to lift my big wheels up or put the hover pads down. There we go. And I made my vehicle a little bit longer too, so the wheels have some more space in between them. So hopefully this will work. All right. All right. Is this working? I think this is working. This appears to be working a little bit better. All right. Here we go. Here we go. Let's turn our kite on. All right. And go. Why is it shaking so weirdly? All right, and put our thrusters. Why is it shaking like that? This is weird. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. What is happening? What is happening? Whoa, what the heck? Oh, this thing behaves not the way I'm expecting. I get, why is it doing that? See, I didn't push suspension on it for a reason. That's because we have downforce. And when you have suspension, the downforce is just going to compress the suspension. So it's not going to be that useful. But this is just weird. It all does seem to be... Maybe I just turned... Oh. I just turned the hover pads off. Maybe we don't need the hover pads after all. So the hover pads are off. And that's what makes it a little bit more stable. It's still shaky. But when I turn the hover pads on, then it just gets glitchy. All right, so let's try this without the hover pads. See if we can still pull the kite up. All right, here we go. All right, no problem. We don't need the hover pads. The hover pads are pointless. All right, put our thrusters on. Look at that. Although, it might be a little bit easier for the kite to pull me without the hover pad. Oh, yeah, look at that. Whoa! Okay, there's like no way. There's no way we're gonna be able to just casually drag this thing around here, I don't think. All right, but I'm gonna try it anyway with the hover pads off. All right, let's go, kite. Let's go. Are you up in the air yet? Oh, yeah, you are. Yeah, you are. No, over here. Over here. Follow me. Follow me. Oh, nope. That's not fun. Oh, that everything went bad. All right, so I'm gonna go back to this design because this was the most stable as far as the not shaking goes. And now what I wanna do is see what is the limit of how long can we make this kite string and still be able to pull the kite? I'm just gonna select this and paste this a couple of times. Like, I don't know, three times. We just added three links to it. Then I'm gonna hope I can attach this without it getting buggy. All right, it looks like it's working so far. So we've added quite a bit of length to this. Let's see if we can actually drive it. All right, kite is activated. It's definitely dragging me a lot more, but once it gets off the ground, we should be able to get some more speed. But the problem is we need speed to get off the ground in the first place. Come on, lift up, lift up. It's starting. It's starting. Come on, more speed. More speed. Yes. 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 Can I even see it from back here now? No, I cannot. Oh, man. It's not lifting up everything, though. I think this is about the limit. I think that's about the limit of what we're going to be able to do with this. We could add more wings and stuff, but, you know what? Let's do it. Let's add more wings and stuff. All right, here we go. We now have a triple layer of wings in hopes that this is going to be able to lift up this new section of string. All right, let's make sure that the wings work. Oh, here we go. Come on. Come on, you can do it. Come on. All right, here we go. Lift off. Lift off. It's lifting off. We're going up. Can it lift everything off the ground, though? I don't know. I don't know if it's going to do... Oh, this is going to pull me, isn't it? Oh, that almost hit the gate. It's doing it. We did it. We did it! It's working! Oh, I don't think we could get much longer than this, to be honest. I'm gonna say this is a tremendously successful episode. We set out to build a kite, and we've built a kite. It totally worked. So I love doing these random experiments in Trailmakers just to see what happens, just unique ideas like this. So leave any comments down below if you have other ideas you'd like to see me try in this game. Unique ideas like this. You know, everyone does like standard vehicles, like a plane, a helicopter, a F1 car, things like that, a walker or whatever. But ideas like this are what really make it interesting when you get to experiment with like just territory that isn't really that explored. So let me know if you have any of those ideas. I would love to try them out. Look at this. Look at that. Oh, this is great. Leave a like if you like this episode and make sure you subscribe if you want to see future episodes like these. Saving this vehicle for future use, because that's fun. Anyway, I'm going to do one final run down the strip here for the outro. Here it goes. Woo! Look at it go. Look at it go. All right. Well, this is the great way to end the video. This has been ScrapMan, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Oh, and here it comes. Oh, I love this thing.